Welcome to today's class, students. Good morning. So in the last class, we studied, we did a revision of what you've studied in third standard, that is 4-digit numbers, and we saw what are 5-digit numbers, correct? So in today's class, we'll be continuing with 5-digit numbers, a quick exercise on 5-digit numbers, and then we will see what are large numbers. All right. So let's start with today's class then. So in the last class, we saw what are 5-digit numbers, right? So 4-digit numbers are nothing but numbers with 4 places, that is 1s, 10s, 100s and 1000s. So this blocks represent the number 1243. This represents 2325. All right. Then here they have asked which number represents shows 3682. So that is this one, 3682. Now 1423, so 1423, the last option, right? We saw all this. Then we saw some terms. What were these terms? Odd numbers. What odd numbers? Numbers which end with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 are called as odd numbers, and even numbers are numbers which end in 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. So for example, for odd numbers are 13, 27, 79, okay, 57, 21, these are all examples for odd numbers. Then coming to even numbers. Even numbers are numbers which end in 1, 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. Alright, so examples are 12, 24, 36, 58, 70 or 100. These are all examples for even numbers. Then we saw what are predecessors. Predecessors of numbers are nothing but they are the numbers that occur just before the given number. For example, if a given number is 16, then its predecessor will be 15 because it occurs just before 16. Then successor of 16, that is the number which comes after the given number. So after 16 we have 17. So successor of 16 will be 17. So these were some terms we saw. Right, then we saw what are 5-digit numbers. So when we add 1 to the greatest 4-digit number, which is 9999, we get 10,000. So 10,000 here is the smallest 5-digit number. Okay, so in 5-digit numbers we have 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000s and 10,000s. So these are 5-digit numbers. Now in today's class, first we will see a few problems on 5-digit numbers and then we'll move on to large numbers. All right. So here we solve questions from 1 to 5 in the last class, and then the quick check I told you to draw the beads to show the numbers on the abacus for your homework, right? So this was for your homework. Now today we'll see exercise 1.1. Okay, so these are all on 5-digit numbers which we saw in the previous class. Okay, so write the number names. So how will you write number names? Now here 7 is in 10,000s place and 1 is in 1000s place. So here 7 and 1, it becomes 71. And since both are in 1000s place, it becomes 71,000. Okay, it becomes 71,000. Then we have 480, right? So that becomes 480. So 71,480. 80 is your number name for the first one. Then coming to question number B, 32504. So 3 is in 10,000s place, 2 is in 1000s place. So that becomes 32,000. Okay, that becomes 32,000. Then I have 504. So that becomes 504 or 504. But nothing is there in tens place, it's just 0. So we directly write 504. Now 89123, how will you write this number? Now 89, correct? So 89,000. Then we have 123, so that becomes 100. 2 is in tens place, so it becomes 23. So that is 23. So 89,000 and 123. So 9 spelling is N-I-N-E, sorry, that is not 89,000 123. Okay, then question number D, here 60512. So that is 60. Nothing is there in thousands place. It is 0, so it is 60,000. Then 5 is in hundreds place. So 500 and 12. 10 is 12, 1 is in tens place and 2 is in ones place. So that becomes 12. So 12. 60,512. Now here at home they have given you for E and F, which means you have to do it for homework. Okay, so E and F is for homework. Now moving on to the next part, that is write in numerals, question number 2. So they have given in words, we have to write in numerals. So 32,000 means 3 is in 10,000's place, 2 is in 1,000's place. Then 361, so 3 is in 100's place, then we have 61, so 61. So 3, 2, 3, 6, 1. Then 90,000. So directly 90,000 they have given means nothing is there in thousands place. So 9 is in 10,000's place and then we have 0 in thousands place. Then 445. So 445, like this, we'll write this number. Then 77,000. So 77,000. Then 23. So that means 23 they have given directly, they have not given any 100. So 100's place is 0 and then 23. So 77023. Then 65,009. So again 65,000 and now nothing is there in 100's place, not in 10's place. So it becomes 0, 0 and in 1's place we have 9. So 65009. Okay, same way do E and F for homework. Now here in this table you have to fill in the predecessor and successor of the given numbers. So here the number is 62318. So just before 62318, what will be the number? It will be 62317. Right, 317, 318 and then successor will be what? 62319. Okay. And then here they have given the predecessor, you have to find the number and the successor. So 47520 is the predecessor. To find the number, what you will do, you will add 1 to it. So that becomes 47521. Right, and the successor will be adding again 1, you will get 47522. So this is the successor. Then 78500 is the number. What will be its predecessor? Before 500 we have 499, so it will be 78,499. And then after 500 we have 501, so 78,501. Only one's place will change in predecessor and successor, not other digits. Okay, here they have given us the successor, we have to find the number and the predecessor. To find the number, what we'll do, we'll subtract 1. So 83,126 minus 1 will be 83,125. And then again when you do minus 1, it will become 83,124. So these were predecessors and successors. Now they have given you number sequences which you have to complete in question 4. So 84,895, 84,896, 84,897, 84,898. It shows that only one's place is changing. So they are adding 1 to 1's place. So 84,898 plus 1 will be 899, right? And then the next term will be 84,000. Now 899 plus 1 will be 900, so that becomes 84,900. Then the B1, 49,996, then 49,997, then 49,998, 49,999. So plus 1 here will be 50,000. Okay, so that is 50,000. Then I have 50,001. Okay, so here we just add 1 to 1's place. Then here 25,120, 25,130, 25,140, 25,150. Here as you see, the tens place is changing. Tens place is increasing by 1. So here 25,150, after that we'll have 25,160, then I'll have 25,170. Okay. Then last 37,200, then 37,300, 37,400 and 37,500. So here hundreds place is increasing by 1, rest all the digits are same. So next after 500 will be 600. So 37,000, 600, then 37,700. Okay, then the same way you do E and F. Okay, in E1 again only one's place is changing, so add one and write. Then in problem F, here hundreds place is increasing, it is increasing by hundreds. So check and solve these problems for homework. That is question E and F for question 1, 2 and 4 is for homework. Okay, then the next topic is something called large numbers. So let's see what are large numbers. So large numbers are nothing but numbers with more number of digits. Okay, so in Indian numeral system, this is number system which we use in India, we have ones, tens, hundreds, thousand and 10,000. So we study till 10,000 in 5-digit numbers, right? So after 10,000 we have lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores and 10 crores. So this is a large number. It has how many digits? It's a 9-digit number. So after 10,000 I have lakhs, then we have 10 lakhs, crores and 10 crores. So here there's an example. We have given a number, I've given you a 9-digit number. So now when I put this number in this place value chart, this is called a place value chart. Okay, so when I put this number, I have 1, 2, 4, 5, 5, 7, 6, 3, 1. So how will I read this? Now 1 and 2 is in crores place, right? It's in crores place. So this becomes 12 crores. Then 45,57,631. So we can go after 10 crores also, but we are studying up to 10 crores. Okay, so from ones to crores, it's a 9-digit number. So this number is 12 crores 45 lakhs 57,631. So this was Indian numeral system. Then we have something called the international numeral system. In international numeral system, this is the numeric system which they use worldwide. Okay, so in ones period we have ones, tens and hundreds, then thousands, 10,000s. But instead of lakhs, what we have in Indian numeral system, in international we have 100,000. So after 10,000 we have 100,000. Same way how here we after tens we have ones, after 10,000 I have 100,000. So 1,000, 10,000 and 100,000. Then after 100,000, now 100,000 is equivalent to 1 lakh of Indian numeral system. Okay, then coming to after 100,000, we have million. Okay, 1 million. Instead of 10 lakhs, I have 1 million. So 10 lakhs is equal to 1 million. After 1 million, I have 10 millions. And after 10 millions, we have something called 100 millions. So 10 millions is here equal to 1 crore and 100 millions is equal to 10 crores. Okay, so here I have given a number. So when I place this number, how will I read it? It will be 14,532,461. Okay, 14,532,467. Okay, so this is international numeral system. So we'll see some problems on Indian numeral system and international numeral system for large numbers. All right. So yeah, the next topic here is large numbers. Now I showed you a place value chart, right? Indian place value chart. So I showed you till 10 crores. So 10 crores, crores, 10 lakhs, lakhs, 10,000s, thousands, hundreds, tens and units or ones. So here this number, what they've given, how will you read this number? 90 crores, 87 lakhs, 65,432. Okay, then international place value chart. Here we have the international place value chart. So ones, tens, hundreds, then 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, then 1 million, 10 million, 100 million. Okay, so these are the two place value charts. Now moving on to exercise 1.2. Now first question they have told, fill up the Indian place value chart for the given numbers. So we have to write it in Indian place values. So here 71. Zero. So we'll start with ones place. So in ones place I have 5, then in tens place I have 1, and then in hundreds place I have 3, thousands place I have 4, in 10,000s place I have 0, so I'll write 0, in lakhs place I have 1, and in 10 lakhs place I have 7. So that is 4,315. Then the next one. Again, here we'll start with units place only or ones place. So I have 5 in ones place, 0 in tens place, okay, then 3 in hundreds place, then 5 in thousands place, 3 in 10,000s place, 0 in lakhs place, and 3 in 10 lakhs place. So this is 30,35,305. Now, next number. We'll start again with ones place. So I have 4 here, then 0, then we have 6, then here we have 8, then 3, and 9. So there's nothing in 10 lakhs place. So this number is 9,38,604. And the last number, we have 0 in ones place, 0 in tens place, 3 in hundreds place, 5 in thousands place, 8 in 10,000s place, 0 in lakhs place, and 1 in 10 lakhs place. So this is 10,85,300. So this is how you fill up this table. You just have to write the numbers in their places. Okay, so lakhs, thousands, and ones was given. So this is how you write the numbers. All right, so moving on to the next page. Now in the next page, write the numbers in Indian system is what they have told us to do. So let's write. So here we have up to how many places? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, and 10 lakhs. Right, so it will be 45 lakhs, then 23,000, I'll write it in below. 23,827. Okay, 827. So this is a number name for question number A. 45,23,827. Now, copy down this, then I'll erase it and I'll show you the B1. Okay, so this was question A. Then question B. We have how many places here? We have up till lakhs. So that becomes 7 lakhs. Whenever we have a 10 lakhs place, we write it as 40, 50, 60, like that, okay? But since we have only lakhs here, we write it as 7 lakhs. Then we don't have anything in 10,000s place, so it becomes 5,000. 5,000, then 148. So 148. 148. So this is the answer for question number B. Copy it down in your books. Okay. And then moving on to question number C. So here in C1 we have up till 10 lakhs place. So 6 and 1. So that becomes 61 lakhs. Okay. And then we don't have anything in 10,000s place. So it becomes only 7,000. Then 53. There's nothing in hundreds place, so it becomes 53. Okay, so 61,07,053. All right, then the last one, we have only lakhs, we don't have 10 lakhs, so 8,37,455. All right, so this is D1. Now E1 you have to do for your homework. So try and do E1 for your homework. Now they have told write the number names in international system. So how will we write an international system? We'll write it as millions, 10 millions, instead of writing it as 10 lakhs and lakhs. Okay. So here, what we'll see? 9 is in ones place, then tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000. Now here, after 10,000, we have 100,000, correct? So 100,000 and then millions. So we have up to millions. So that becomes 7 millions. Then 453,000 and 129. Okay, 29. All right, so this is A1. Now moving on to B1, we have 2,049,802. All right, so this was question B. Now same way, do for homework C, D and E. Solve question C, D and E for homework. And also question 4, I want you to try it for homework. You have to write these numbers in, number names in numerals. So whatever is given at home, do it for homework, and question 4 also for homework. And question C and D of question 3 for your homework. Alright, so I'll see you all in the next class, students. That is next week. Alright, thank you.